binary search tree. A binary search tree is a binary tree that is either empty or not containing a key value left child, right child. So by analyzing the above definition, we know that the BST comes in two variants, namely empty BST and non-empty BST. So empty BST has no further structure, while non-empty BST has three components. So its components are left subtree, the key in the left child of a node, if exist, is less than the key in its parent node. And second, the key in the right child of a node, if exist, is greater than the key in the parent node. So the left and right subtrees of the root are again binary search tree. Operations performed by binary search tree. So creation, traversing, counting internal node, external node, counting total number of node. So here it's non-leaf nodes. And this one is for leaf nodes. So counting total number of nodes, finding the height of the tree, insertion of searching, insertion of new node, searching for an element, finding the smallest element and finding the largest element, and deletion of a node. So binary search tree allow three type of traversal through its nodes. They are as follows: pre-order traversal, in-order traversal, post-order traversal. Pre-order traversal. In pre-order traversal, we perform the following three operations: visit the node, traverse the left subtree in pre-order, and traverse the right subtree in pre-order. In order, traverse the left subtree in order, visit the node, and traverse the right subtree in order. Post order traverse. The traverse left the subtree in post order, then right subtree in post order, and visit node. Insertion of a node into a BST. A binary search tree is constructed by the repeated insertion of new nodes into a binary tree structure. Insertion must maintain the order of the tree. The value to the left of a given node must be less than that node, and value to the right node must be greater. In inserting a new node, the following two tasks are performed. Tree search to determine where the node is to be inserted. On completion of search, the node is inserted into tree. So deletion of node in a binary search tree. The algorithm to delete a node with a key from binary search tree. So here are the three cases. If the node to be deleted has no child or no sons, then it may be deleted without further adjustment to the tree. If the node to be deleted has only one subtree, then its only son can be moved up to take its place. The node be deleted as two subtrees, then in order successor S must take its place. The in order successor cannot have left subtree. Thus the right son of S can be moved up to take the place S. So here is the question: what are the different ways of traversing a binary search tree? So with previous slide, you can give the answer from this. So the different ways of traversing a binary search tree are pre-traversal, pre-order, in-order, and post-order. So here is the answer of this question. So this is a very important question. And what are the major feature of binary search tree? So in this slide, these are the major features of binary search tree. Left subtree if exists is less than the root, and right subtree if exists is greater than its root, and same with the subtree of subtree. So now come to the next topic. This is AVL tree. It's very important. AVL trees. An AVL tree is a binary search tree which has the following properties. The subtree of every node differs in height by at most one. Every subtree is an AVL tree. So AVL stands for the name GM Adelson. Velesky and E.M. Landis, two Russian mathematicians who come up with this method of keeping the tree balanced. An AVL tree is a binary search tree which has the balance property and in addition to its key. So each node stores an extra piece of information. The current balance of its subtree, the three possibilities are there. Left high balance factor is here is minus 1. The left child has height that is greater than the right child by 1 here. Then balanced, and let me do this. And balanced factor 0. Both children have same height. Right high. Balanced factor here is plus 1. So the right child has height that is greater by 1. An AVL tree which remains balanced guarantees 0 log n search time even in the worst case. So here n is the number of nodes. The AVL tree data structure achieves this property by placing restriction on the difference in heights between the subtrees of a given node and rebalancing the tree even if it violates these restrictions. So now come to insertion of a node into an AVL tree. Nodes are initially inserted into an AVL tree in the same manner as an ordinary binary search tree. So, however, the insertion of algorithm for an AVL tree travels back along the path it took to find the point of insertion and checks the balance at each node on the path. If node is found that is unbalanced, if it is balanced, factor is either minus 2 or plus 2, then rotation is performed. Based on the inserted node, position related to node being examined. So, the unbalanced node. So, deletion of a node in an AVL tree. The deletion algorithm for AVL tree is little more complex as there are several extra steps involved in deletion of node. If the node is not leaf node, then it has at least one child. Then the node must be swept with either its in-order successor or predecessor. Once the node has been swept, we can delete it. If a deletion node was originally a leaf node, then it can simply be removed. As done in insertion, we traverse back up the path to the root node, checking the balance of all nodes along the path. If unbalanced, then the respective node is found and appropriate rotation is performed to balance the node. So here is AVL tree operation. So AVL trees and nodes it contain must meet strict balance requirement to maintain O log n search time. So these balance restrictions are maintained using various rotation operation. The four possible rotation that can be performed on unbalanced AVL tree given below is left rotation, right rotation, and left to right and right to left. So these are the four rotations in AVL tree. So let's discuss about its structure. So it's its structure. Struct AVL. Struct node star left. Int info. Int BF. And here is BF is balancing factor. And info of the value on the node is this. So struct node star right. This is a structure of AVL tree. Application of AVL tree, where it is applied. AVL trees are applied in the following situation. There are a few insertion and deletion operations where and short search time is needed. and input data is shorted or nearly shorted. So applications where it is used are dictionaries, telephone directory, symbol table for compiler, storing business record and file system. A classic problem in computer science is how to store information dynamically. So as to allow for quick lookup, this searching problem arises often in dictionary, telephone directory, symbol tables for compiler and while storing business records. So the records are stored in balanced binary tree based on the keys, alphabetical or numerical order. So the balanced nature of the tree limits its height to O log n, where n is the number of inserted records. AVL tree are very fast on searches and replacement, but have moderately high cost for addition and deletion. If application does a lot more searches and replacement than it does addition deletion, the balanced AVL tree binary tree is a good choice for the data structure. The AVL tree also has application in file system. Then next topic is B-trees. B-trees are special MRE balanced trees used in databases because their structure allow record to be inserted, deleted, retrieved with guaranteed worst case performance. So B-trees specialize in multi-way tree. In B-tree, each node may contain large number of keys. The number of subtrees of each node may also be large. So a B-tree is designed to branch out in this large number of directions and to contain a lot of keys in each node so that the height of this tree is relatively small. This means that only a small number of nodes must be read from disk to retrieve an item. So a B-tree of order M is multi-way search tree of order M such that. So all leaves are on the bottom level. So these are the B-tree order search of order M such that all leaves are on the bottom level. All internal nodes except root node have at least M by 2 non-empty children. So the root node can have as few 2 children if it is internal node and can have no children if the root node is a leaf node. Each leaf node must contain at least M by 2 minus 1 keys. So if we discuss about its structure, so its structure looks like this: struct B tree, and here is curly bracket, then int count, the number of keys stored in the current node, the item type key 3, array of 4 to hold 3 keys, and long branch 4 is array of fake pointer record numbers. Then here is curly bracket and semicolon. Then operations on B tree. So following are various operations that can be performed on B tree: search operation, create operation, and insert operation. So B trees strive to minimize disk access, and the nodes are usually stored on disk. All the nodes are assumed to be stored in secondary storage. It must be noted, all the nodes are assumed to be stored in secondary storage rather than primary storage. All the references to a given node are preceded by read operation. Then similarly, once a node is modified, it is no longer needed. It must return out to a secondary storage with the write operation. So here is the algorithm of B tree. Here is I is less than minus 1, and while I is less than equal to n. So you can see their algorithm. So the search operation is similar in two binary tree. Instead of choosing between a left and right child as in binary tree, a B tree search must make n way choice. So the correct child is chosen by performing linear search of the value in the node. After finding the value greater than or equal to desired value, the child pointed to the immediate left to that value is followed. So the exact running time of search operation depends upon the height of the tree. So we can create, insert, and plus create and insert operations in B tree. The application of B tree. The database is a collection of data organized in fashion that facilitates updation, retrieval, and management of data. Searching an unindexed database containing a keys will have a worst case running 0, and if the same type is indexed with the B tree, then the same search operation will run in 0 log n time. So indexing large amount of data can significantly improve search performance. If we go to the summary of all these, the striking feature of binary search tree is that all the elements of left subtree of the root will be less than those of the right subtree. So the same rule is applicable for all subtrees in BST. An AVL tree is a height balance tree. So in some places the question came is height balance tree. So you can understand that AVL tree is a height balance tree. The heights of the left and right subtree of root of an AVL tree differ by 1. The same rule is applicable for all subtrees of AVL tree. A B tree is a MRE binary tree. There can be multiple elements in each node of B tree. B tree are used extensively to insert, delete and retrieve record from databases. So in our next video we will discuss another topic like Dijkstra Prim's algorithm and Kruskal. Okay, thanks for watching.